Sloot led the Swede after the first two of seven events before her left thigh proved too painful to continue. She ran the best 100 metre hurdles in 13.11 seconds before matching the Swede in the high jump with 1 metre and 89.
Perhaps Abney wasn't at her best, hampered by injury, but her competitive spirit carried her to glory.
200 metres, close to running in heat 4, didn't look at her fluid best, but it was a good race though for the British pair Jessica Ennis and Kelly Sutherland, both finished first and second ahead of Kluft. Overall, the Swede leads 124 points ahead of Sutherland, and Ennis a further 5 back in third as they head to day 2. Following the withdrawal of Eunice Barber, favourite Carolina Kluft looks set to cruise for the heptathlon title. Kluft was in second place when her rival pulled out in the shot put. The Swede produced the second best throw to take the lead. Local favourite Carolina Kluft was dancing with joy as she was outstanding in the women's heptathlon event. She took the title after an impressive performance in the long jump. She scored 801 points in the javelin. She also produced a fine performance and then finished 12th in the dreaded 800 metres, but still walked away with victory.
Well, it's been up and down. Yesterday morning, when I warmed up, it was totally bad. I felt bad and felt like I was not able to be able to compete good during the 2 days. But as soon as I came into the track and the crowd was screaming at me, I felt great. It's a wonderful feeling, and I'm just now I feel totally empty because all the feelings just came over me, and well, I'm just happy.
Host nation Sweden had a decent championship, even if Kajsa Bergqvist and Stefan Holm failed to win the high jump gold the home fans hoped for. One woman who raised the pressure was Carolina Kluft,